Welcome back to another disappointment review. No, delivered reviewed. Hopefully no more disappointments. This week we're trying Taco Bell Mexican inspired food. As I say, this week, Taco Bell and, you know, burritos, tacos, nachos and quesadillas, etc. And I've just never had them before. I've always thought about going into Taco Bell and just then never have. This was kind of years ago, sort of, you know, more in Nottingham than more than a few years, obviously, with COVID and all that kind of madness. But I've always thought, yeah, let's try Taco Bell. I've just never tried them, even delivery. So now's the time. Let's try Taco Bell. And in all honesty, there wasn't much of a disappointment apart from the delivery driver. But I'm not going to go into that. Issues with delivery, etc. So here we are, the creator, ex-Marine apparently, of Taco Bell, Glenn Bell, 1962. Going a long, long time and still going strong from what I can see, and you'll see obviously on the review. So to start off with, it was a box meal, but there was no box. That's the only disappointment. The chicken tenders that you can see there weren't, as you can see, very big, weren't very thick, kind of probably hammered flat, a little bit dry, and the coating was a little bit too crunchy, like it had been in the fryer just a little bit too long, or it had been left out a little bit too long. So the sauce to go with it was definitely needed, I'd say. But as far as chicken tenders go, they looked like they were genuine chicken breasts, so they weren't formed chicken or processed chicken. So they were pretty good, but as far as chicken tenders go, KFC, etc., a lot juicier. You know, you can always tell from one place to the other when you do get a bad chicken tender. And I say bad, they weren't that good. They're just a little bit dry. So reasonable tenders, I would say. And just as a side, I probably should have had the rice, but we'll probably try that at some point in the future. The fries were pretty nice. You don't get that many of them, but the fries were pretty nice. If they'd have been a little bit hotter, obviously the distance, I think it was like 5 miles into the middle of town. So just for the fact that they appeared on Deliveroo, I thought, why not? Let's just try them. So you can see there, obviously, what I ordered. As I say, it was a box meal, but without the box. So maybe they just forgot the box. But they were decent fries. They were seasoned, kind of like had a little bit of a... I'm not sure what the coating, sort of seasoning on them was, but like an orange kind of colour to it. It kind of reminded me of the Perry fries, but they were pretty nice. Soft on the outside, would have been crunchy. Soft on the inside, would have been crunchy on the outside, but is what it is with distance. The taco, I've never had a taco before, but I've kind of made them at home many times. Pretty nice, crunchy. I kind of broke it myself like an idiot, so can't really say anything about that. You see a little picture there of tacos. And they're kind of just a quick food, I guess. Beef or seasoned ground beef on the bottom, lettuce, and I think a bit of cheese in there. Was pretty nice. The problem is you bite into a crunchy taco and it just kind of explodes and it literally went everywhere. But as far as taste goes, I would say, you know, they were pretty nice. Again, not much of a disappointment. It was kind of what was advertised is what you got to a degree. All right, a little bit of marketing hype in terms of the picture that you'll see in a minute, or more to the point now. But it wasn't far off. The taco wasn't far off. The burrito wasn't far off. You know, it was actually pretty good. I'll give them fair dues. They're not gone like a McDonald's trying to draw you in and then you just get a load of rubbish. And again, I know as somebody said, I can make this stuff at home, but that's not the point. The point is that you're paying for not just the delivery, but for a restaurant, whoever it may be, to produce decent food as far as I'm concerned. It doesn't matter if it's fast food. On to the burrito. And I thought, you know, let's cut it in half so you can kind of see into the middle. And it was toasted on the outside or grilled. Well kind of packed, it wasn't kind of empty, a bit like the Twister with KFC. There was loads and loads of space in there, you know, so it kind of is what it is. But as you can see there, it was filled pretty well, probably a little bit too much lettuce, I'd say. They could have added another chicken tender in there. The chicken tenders were a little bit bigger, so I'm not really sure in terms of the burrito, but as a burrito goes, it was pretty nice. Jalapeno sauce, lettuce, tomatoes, cheese, and obviously the crispy, which is part of the title, the crispy chicken. And it was pretty good. You know, I literally can't complain at it. You know, as I say, maybe one more chicken tender in there would have been nice, but as a meal, It wasn't bad. But the only actual disappointment was these churros. They were just not thick enough. So the outside was most of the kind of the deep fried, and the oil kind of got to it a little bit too much, as you can see there. Not much to the middle of it. A lot of cinnamon on it, which was kind of a little bit overpowering, I think, really. But they weren't bad, you know, as a dessert, probably thrown in as the meal, as it were. They weren't bad, but I'm going to say they were average. I mean, ultimately, you'll see in 2 seconds, the burrito, 7.5, could have had a little bit more tender. Taco was 8 out of 10, tender 6.5, fries 8, and churros 5 out of 10. I appreciate all the subscribers. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe, and we're on to the next one next week.